Hello and welcome to this second in this series of videos where we're looking at twin and CPC cables. In this video we're going to be particularly focusing on the typical sizes of twin and CPC cables that are available, and we're also going to consider how the CPC size relates to the main conductor size. So first up on our list of conductor sizes is the smallest size available for twin and CPC, and that is 1 millimeter squared. So what that means is that the cross-sectional area of the line and the neutral conductors are 1 millimeter squared in their cross-sectional area. Now this is the only twin and CPC cable where the CPC is actually the exact same size as the line and neutral conductors. So the line and neutral are 1 millimeter squared, and the CPC is also 1 millimeter squared. Now you'll start to notice as we go up the cable sizes that the CPC will start being a different size to the line and neutral. So we'll have a look at our next size up. Our next size up is 1.5 millimeter squared. So again, that's referring to the cross-sectional area of the conductor is 1.5 millimeter squared. If you're ever unsure about your conductor size, most cables manufactured now will actually have the size of the cable printed on there, embossed into the outer sheath, so you can actually get a bit of a clue there as to what size it is. So here we've got 1.5 mil for the line and the neutral, and then the CPC is 1 millimeter. So you can see there that it is half a millimeter squared smaller than the line and the neutral. Now the main reason for that is that, as we said in a previous video, this CPC should never have any electricity running through it. That's the ideal. It should never have any electricity running through there at all. However, if a fault occurs, this CPC may carry some current, but it will only carry current for a very short period of time, which means that it's not going to get a long time to get as hot as the line or the neutral may. Therefore, this conductor can be smaller than the line and neutral. Now, there's ways of proving that in the regulations, but we'll cover that in a slightly more advanced video. Our next conductor size up is 2.5 mil. So this is a very common size that we use for socket circuits. And this is 2.5 millimeter squared for the line and neutral. And the CPC is 1.5 mil. So again, you can see that that is 1 millimeter squared smaller than the line and neutral conductors. So typically used for socket outlets. And this next size up is 4 millimeter. Now at this point, you'll notice that the conductor type changes for the line and the neutral. You see there that in the previous cables, the conductors were solid. They were made from a single solid piece of copper wire. But here, these conductors are actually stranded. So they're made out of 7 much smaller pieces of solid wire that are then all twisted together to make one conductor. So the reason for that is that as you get past 2.5 mil in size, if these were solid conductors, it would make this cable very, very stiff and very difficult to bend and to install. So that's why it goes up to a stranded size. So we've got 4 mil squared for the line and neutral conductors, and we've got 1.5 mil squared for the CPC. So now we get into a position where actually this conductor is getting quite a bit smaller than this one. We're talking about 2.5 mil smaller. So it's getting considerably smaller than the line and neutral. But again, remember, this should never conduct electricity. If it ever does conduct electricity, it should only be for a very short period of time. 4 mil cable is often used on socket circuits where the runs are a little bit longer and there might be issues with volt drop. And also it might just be used for standalone supplies to pieces of equipment with slightly higher current ratings than normal. Next on our list of conductors, we've got 6 mil. So that is 6 mil for the line and the neutral conductors. And now we're looking at 2.5 mil for the CPC. So 6 mil for the line and the neutral, 2.5 mil for the CPC. So again, this conductor is smaller still than these two. This size of conductor in a domestic installation would typically be used for a cooker. Can't state categorically that it will suit every single cooker installation, but it is typically used for that. We then move on to some much larger cable sizes. So now we've jumped from 6 mil all the way up to 10 mil. So this is a 10 mil conductor on the line and the neutral. And you'll notice as well there's another change in that the CPC has now become stranded as well as the line and the neutral conductors. So we've got a 10 mil line and neutral conductor, and the CPC is a 4 mil conductor. So again, this is quite a lot smaller than these two, but that's no there's no issue with safety there, because it should only ever conduct electricity for the briefest of moments in fault condition. A 10 mil cable will typically be used in a domestic installation for a shower installation. Again, you can't guarantee that every shower will need 10 mil, but that's a typical size that is used. And finally, we've got our largest size of twin and CPC. This is 16 mil. This is quite a big cable. It's not all that common that this will be used in a domestic installation, but we've got a 16 mil line and neutral conductors, and we've got a 6 mil CPC. So again, we've got to the point now where this is really getting quite small. This is less than half the size of these two. But again, there's no safety implications there because lots of calculations have been done to prove that this conductor is quite safe to be this size. A 16 mil cable might be used on some very large powered showers. It may also be used as a sub-main cable for getting from one consumer unit to another. And it's fairly rare that this gets used in domestic installations. You might not come across this that often, but it is available should you ever require it. So Gary, we've covered the typical cable sizes that we can expect to be working with when we're working with twin CPC. How's this going to fit in with the learner experience? What are they going to know from this? How are they going to benefit?
Early low level stuff, they've got to be able to identify the right size cable for the right type of circuit. So we'd be expecting our learners to know that 1 and 1.5 millimeter square cable would be used for lighting circuits. And then we've got to distinguish the cable sizes for an A1, A2 and A3 arrangement of socket outlets. Sure. As we move towards a level three course, we'll be looking at the design elements and sizing cables. So it'll get a little bit more difficult the longer you're with us.
Yeah, so at that point we'll start to look at not necessarily typical circuits, but circuits that you design from scratch. And of course, then we realise that there's a lot more freedom about selecting your conductor size and making sure you get it right for the load. So that's going to be a lot of fun and very interesting to deliver. And the learners will enjoy that while they're here.
I think it's that time.
Shall we?
We'll try.
We hope this video has been some help.